April 13th, 2008. Why is there so much clarification needed in an online world? A situation cropped up this evening that made me stop and think once again about this sometimes confusing, frequently fragile, and often combative virtual world we live in on JTV. I was in the Quintano Media channel for a while tonight as I was sorting out my most recent Justopia.com grocery receipts, and I'll admit I was not paying full attention to the broadcast. I had come in from a relaxing few hours out with a friend and signed on to see what was going on at JTV on a Sunday afternoon. Anthony had asked me for some blog help just before I ran out to lunch, so when I got back I thought I'd stop by to see if he had things sorted out. As I was working on organizing my papers, Anthony mentioned that one of the JTV viewers, participants, broadcasters, named Designer Girl had been in a terrible accident. I am familiar with Designer Girl as a frequent face during the Magic Rich show. I referred to her as a Magic Rich fan, but apparently that hit a nerve with some of her friends. I lurk in Magic Rich's room a few times a week, and I don't recall a time when Designer Girl wasn't in there, manning the room, helping out, keeping things under control. My response to the question was never intended to be negative, disparaging, or hurtful. However, it seems I caused a bit of a stir with some of her pals. In my dictionary, fan is nothing more than a descriptive noun, one of an admirer, devotee. In my time here, I've witnessed a lot of stuff on JTV. What I have learned is that this is an absolute virtual reality, but that real life, living, breathing people are on the other side of the keyboard, and that they have feelings too. Words often seem to fly around without much consideration of the consequences, in many cases, and I can only begin to imagine what goes on in private messages, both instant and email. Things around JTV are quite often upbeat, but at times people get hurt, people get angry, and people silently brood over actions and comments that are put forth. I'm one of them, and I was just a bit surprised to receive pointed mail from someone I'm not sure I've ever even spoken with in the past. Participation as a chatter for me has been waning in the past 7 months, and when I'm in a room, I often won't even bother to log in. That helps to keep me from participating in chat. In most rooms, it just seems increasingly more difficult to make myself understood. I hear my voice just as though I'm saying it out loud, and in turn, I hear what the other person is saying to me as though I'm really hearing it, but I think I often misread situations. Okay, scratch that. I know I often misread what's being communicated to me on the screen. I don't feel like having live voice conversations with most people I communicate with on JTV, but geez, sometimes I think it's the only way I can feel comfortable that I have understood the message, or more importantly, that I've delivered the message accurately and appropriately. That said, I hope Designer Girl is on her way to a speedy and full recovery.